It is cold and rainy outside, so I decided to record another new episode of Azure Vlog. In this Azure Vlog, I'm going to talk about virtual network service endpoints. Service endpoints extend your virtual network address space with Azure services. And with Azure services, I mean Azure resources that are living in the public space. For example, storage accounts and database services. Normally, you can only access those resources via the internet, and with service endpoints, you have your private connection from your virtual network to the platform as a service resource. You only have a connection from your virtual network to your storage account, for example. That makes it a private connection, which is more secure than having your transactions and data going over the public internet. It will also help us with the optimal routing from our Azure virtual network to the platform as a service services. Normally, when you access a public service in Azure from out your virtual network, everything is routed via the public internet. When you enable service endpoints, that's no longer the case. We have a shorter connection via the Azure backbone to the Azure public service. Service endpoints are also quite simple to set up. It's just a couple of clicks and your storage account is no longer accessible through the internet, but only via your virtual network. Before I show you how to set up service endpoints, let's first talk about how they are working. I get a lot of questions when I talk about this subject, and those questions are mainly, is my Azure public service getting an IP address in my virtual network? No, that's not the case. What actually happens is that Microsoft creates a private connection from your virtual network to the Azure public service. When you look at the route table of your virtual network, you will see that there is a new entry that will lead to the public service. So let's get into the technical stuff. I will demonstrate to you how you can enable service endpoints. But before I show you how you can enable service endpoints, I want to show you what's happening under the hood of Azure. I already have set up a storage account with service endpoints enabled to one of my virtual networks. And when you look at a virtual machine, at the network interface of a virtual machine, you have a thing called effective routes. There you can see what routes are actually in the table that your virtual machine is using, the route table that your virtual machine is using. And when you look at the table, you will see that there are two entries added. And those are the entries that are required for the service endpoint. So what Microsoft is basically doing, it's creating an underwater connection to via the Azure backbone. And it adds some extra routes in your virtual network to go over that connection. So now I'm going to show you how you can set up service endpoints for a storage account. And I demonstrate this with a storage account, but it also applies at this moment to Azure databases. I already pre-filled in a form. And when we go all the way down, there is an option Virtual Networks Preview. We have to enable this. This will enable the service endpoints. And we have a virtual network to select. In this case, I'm going for my VNet 01. And I will enable it for the default subnet. I only have one subnet in this test virtual network. Let's create this one. And while this deployment is running, I will show you what's running in this network. In this network, I have a couple of virtual machines. And in this demonstration, we are going to have a look at the test 02 VM. On this VM, I have a Storage Explorer installed, and we will see that we can access the storage account from the Storage Explorer that's running on that VM. And I also have a Storage Explorer running on a local VM that's running on my laptop. And we will see that we are not able to access the storage account from there. So, the storage account is ready. When I go and have a look at the virtual machine, we will see that the effective routes have changed. There should be a new entry over there. And I heard that it can take up some time for the routes to be in there. So, So we will see, you'll see the virtual network service endpoint is in here. Now let's go to that particular VM and have a look at Storage Explorer. Storage Explorer is a free tool that you can download from the internet, which will help you to manage your storage accounts. You can browse through your storage account, upload files, etc. So this is a great tool to test if our storage account is working correctly. First, I will sign into my Azure account. So we can see all my subscriptions over in here. Let's have a look at the subscription where we just created that storage account. We created this storage account. So let's create a new container in the storage account and upload some files in there. Create the blob container, test. Test two. So we now created some containers. Let's upload some files. First I have to create a file. And I'm going for just a silly empty notepad file. Let's upload this. And we see that the file has uploaded correctly to the storage account. We can now find this file in our storage account. Now let's do the same thing with the virtual machine that's running on this notebook. This notebook is not part of the virtual network in Azure, so we should not have access to that storage account. I also have to log in to Azure on my local virtual machine. Just like the Azure VM, you will see all my subscriptions listed over here. When I go to the storage account, we get an error. We are not able to access the storage account from this machine that's not part of the virtual network we are using. When you set up a service endpoint, they're currently in public preview, you have to take in account that they are currently not available for all resources. Today, service endpoints are only available for storage accounts and database services. There is also a limitation in regions. We cannot have a service endpoint to an Azure public service that is living in another region than where our virtual network is living. Another limitation, which is actually quite straightforward, is that service endpoints are only support with ARM, the Azure Resource Manager. The classic Azure infrastructure does not support service endpoints. As a best practice, when you start with Azure today, always go for ARM, Azure Resource Manager. So now you know how service endpoints work. Service endpoints are your private connection from your virtual network to the Azure public services. At this moment, only Azure database services and storage accounts are supported. But later on, we will see that more and more services will be supported with service endpoints. With that, I would like to close this Azure vlog. If you found this interesting, please hit the blue thumbs up button. And of course, subscribe to this channel. See you in the next one. Bye.